Hello, everybody. This is Steve Grizzetti, co-founder of MoviePix.com and author of the MoviePix.com Guide to Adobe Premiere Elements. And here we are in Premiere Elements, getting ready to start a slideshow. Now, a question that sometimes comes up, is there an easy way to set up a slideshow that changes slides and rhythm to the music? And the answer is yes, there are some tools built into the program for helping you do that. So in order to create that effect, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the music. And I've got a song called A Little Less Conversation. Elvis made it famous. Great little song. Drag it down to the music track here. We can ignore this. We're not going to change project settings based on that music. Now, before I add my still photos or my slides, first thing I want to do is take that music and then map out its beats. And I can do that by right-clicking on it, selecting clip, and from the clip menu, selecting beat detect. Did you even know this tool was in there? Pretty cool. It will base its rhythms on the beats of music in the song. And so let's leave it at its default setting right now, and we'll click OK. And the program creates for us, can you see along the top of the timeline here, these little blue markers. These little blue markers are beats based on beats in the music. So I'm going to zoom in on the timeline a little bit just by pressing the plus button on my keyboard a couple times. And then I'm going to select all of my still photos, just by holding down the shift key and selecting the first and last. Now, I have to tell you, there used to be a tool built into the program that would do this automatically for you. If you right click on your selection here in the project assets panel, there's the option to create slideshow, a little hidden tool. And it used to be you could place the images and clips at unnumbered markers. In other words, the program would automatically create a slideshow that changed slides in rhythm to the music. That's no longer available. It's grayed out. You can see the ghost of it still here, though. So we're not going to do that. I select cancel. I'm just going to drag these all down to my timeline and put them on video track one. Once I've done that, I'm going to click off them, so I'm not selecting them. And then it's simply a matter of trimming each one to match those beat markers. So if I drag on this end of this clip, watch what happens when I get to the beat marker. See that little arrow? That's an indicator that says you're matching the beat. I need only do that for each slide. And you can see this only takes a couple of minutes. But these slides are now going to change to the beat of the music. And just to show you what that looks like, let's play a couple minutes of the song. Put the playhead back to the beginning of the timeline and press, let's close this panel, and press play. And you can see how it works. Very nice. Did a pretty good job here of matching the beats to the beats of the music itself. There are manual ways to do that too, if you don't trust the automatic tool in the program. But most often it gives me about what I'd like. Now, to make the slideshow more interesting, I wish I could tell you there was an automatic pan and zoom tool built into the program. To do that, you're going to have to use one of the slideshow creators that are built into the Elements Organizer. But in this particular case, the only way to add pans and zooms sort of automatically is to go over to the effects panel here on the toolbar on the right-hand side of the program and select presets. And here in the presets, if you scan down far enough, you can see some pans, some horizontal image zooms, and some horizontal image pans. These will create pans and zooms over your clips. You can just drag them right on down there. And you can get some pans and zooms. Unfortunately, you can either pan or you can zoom. You can't combine the two, but here's what it looks like. So there are some automatic systems here for creating pans and zooms in the program. Most of the time I'm doing it myself manually using the keyframe controller. There is a tool built in here under the tools button on the toolbar on the right called pan and zoom. I recommend you stay as far as you can from that. That's a terrible little semi-automatic tool that does a lot of things that I spend a lot of time undoing and fixing whenever I use it. So I recommend you manually create your pans and zooms or use those presets that are built into the effects panel. Now, if you want to know more about all the things this wonderful program can do, I hope you'll check out the tips and tutorials at moviepix.com. If you want to know everything about Premiere Elements and all the hidden gems that are inside it, you'll want to check out the moviepix.com guide to Adobe Premiere Elements. You'll find that at Amazon.com. I'm Steve. I'm the guy who wrote the book, and I hope to see you again real soon. Take care.